Hello everyone and welcome to Suga's Kitchen. First, a very happy new year to all of you. And today's recipe is three types of rasam. Rasams are thin lentil stews or soups. It's a speciality of the South Indian kitchen. In Tamil Nadu we call it rasam, in Karnataka we call it saaru. But by whatever name you call it, it's one of the appetizers in a South Indian meal. It follows the second course in the Elai Saddi or the feast, but as a daily taking of an appetizer, a rasam is a must in a Tamil household. There are many varieties of rasams and some are more popular than the others. Today I'll just show you three rasams. And rasams are a favorite in all seasons. In India, being a tropical country, we have four seasons and more than four. We have spring, summer, autumn, late winter, early winter and the monsoon. During the monsoons, our metabolism gets a little idle and it is at this time that hot, tangy rasams come into the picture. Even otherwise, in the hot season, rasam helps in digestion and is very much a part of the South Indian meal from all ages, age groups. So today I am going to show you a good rasam. Good rasam is the rasam that you can make in a jiffy. A quick rasam when you are tired and you are just coming back from work and you are short of time, you can make a quick rasam to add to your hot rice along with some vegetables of course. So this is imli or tamarind. I've taken this much only for two people because I get a good extract of this imli in the Yelagiri hills, but depending on the extract that you get, you can increase or decrease the quantity, to which I've added one tumbler of water. So this is imli water which is boiling, and to this I'm just going to add some salt at your requirement and some turmeric powder. Now this is an instant rasam, so let's say that this is boiled, the imli aroma is on, and what I'm going to do is I'm putting a kadai and I'm going to season the rasam. So it's a quick making of a rasam. So we have certain ingredients that go into it. So what we will add to this clarified butter or ghee is mustard, and then let the mustard crackle. Meantime I'll show you the ingredients: dhania, turmeric. I've taken everything a little more because I like it tangy. Jeera, pepper and methi. And then a good red chilli. So these are the things that will go into this good rasam. We are not grinding, we are not pressure cooking dhal. It's made in a quick way. So we are just adding imli, salt and turmeric. Last we will add some hing. So when the mustard crackles, what happens is these ingredients will be added in a raw form to the ghee and tempered into the rasam. So it steeps in the rasam and the imli and adds flavor and aroma. So now I'm adding the turmeric, the dhania, methi, a little jeera, pepper and the red chilli. So just give it a stir. And as you stir it, you will find the aroma of the spices. And these spices will get into the imli water which is already boiled to add flavor to the rasam. This is very good for the monsoon season when it's rainy and you're wet and tired. can have this in the evening or afternoon, but better to take it hot. So perfect. This is called the good rasam because basically good means making in a jiffy, making it very fast. So that is the good rasam. The next one is the kodlu rasam, the horse gram. This is the horse gram. What I am going to do is, I have dry fried the horse gram, ToorDhal, Dhania, Jeera, pepper, red chilli, and I have got a powder like this. So when you dry fry it, first put in the horse gram because it takes a little longer to fry. Then add the ToorDhal, the Dhania, Jeera, pepper and the red chilli. And this is the powder. These ingredients have been powdered in a blender. So what I am going to do is, this is the imli water boiling. So again, let us add the salt to your requirement, the turmeric powder, and as it boils, along with the powder of the kodlu and the ingredients that I showed you, I have also taken a tomato puree, a fairly big tomato like this, which I have pureed. So I am adding that, and then this will also be spicy, and this horse gram is very good for health. It has enough nutrition to compensate for the pressure cooked dal, and much more than that, it's also very good for arthritis, because in the Ayurvedic system or the traditional South Indian cooking, we believe that it supplies heat to the body. So in the monsoon and the cold winter months, when you take horse gram in the form of a rasam, it helps your arthritis, knee pain, joint pain, and this is a traditional belief which we have followed for generations. It is handed down from my grandparents, through my parents to me and to my kids. So I believe that these ingredients help. So after you powder, it's not a very fine powder, it's fairly coarse. Now this is boiling. You added the tomato puree. Now let us add this powder, the horse gram, ToorDhal and the other ingredients. So I will post it in the description box so that you will know what ingredient goes into what. Now here also we need to temper, and for this, this is clarified butter or ghee. Clarified butter or ghee also is a good tradition in the South, and for tempering for rasams and all that, we always use this. So here's the mustard. Since many of these ingredients are already in this, I am only adding mustard. Let the mustard crackle. Till then, let the rasam boil. There is no need to add pressure cooked dal in this because the kodlu powder or the horse gram powder is good enough. This will have a very dark color sometimes because the horse gram that I bought today is not as black as some of the times that you get. So the color, don't worry about it. The mustard is crackling. Let me add the hing, the asafoetida, which is a must in most South Indian dishes. second rasam that is ready. It all takes a very short time. And this one, the third rasam, I'll bring it there so that the camera can focus better. This is a very very special rasam called pineapple rasam. So now in the Yelagiri Hills we get good pineapples, and I've made a pineapple puree. So this is the pineapple puree. What has gone into this pineapple puree is bits of pineapple, red chilli. It is not a dry chilli. I found it in the garden, fairly ripe, but you can use green chillies also, and a good piece of ginger. So pineapple, ginger and chilli. So you can imagine what a tang it will create in the rasam to, you know, whet your appetite and tingle your taste buds. Rasam is very much a part of the South Indian meal. I can't explain how tasty it is. And this is pressure cooked dhal water. You just pressure cook Toor dhal and dilute it. So this water also, we have to add salt and turmeric powder. Turmeric powder is a must in all South Indian dishes. Turmeric has curcumin, and I have posted some recipes on the turmeric, raw turmeric pickle. Please go through it. You can eat that pickle also with rasam. Now I am going to add the pressure cooked dhal. Let me keep this ready. And this is the pineapple puree. Pineapple, red chilli and ginger. It will give a distinct tang. And pineapple rasam is a favorite even in big wedding feasts. You can have it in a glass to drink, or you can eat it with hot rice. And then I have also cut bits of pineapple, which will be added last. I can already get the smell of the pineapple, the tomato puree, ginger and chilli. Now I am going to add the bits of pineapple. Now to this also we add clarified butter, which is called ghee, and no cooking is complete without the mustard crackling and getting into the menu. I'll add some hing too. The salt and other ingredients are to your taste. I have not added imli in this because the pineapple here has a sour taste. But if you find that the pineapple is a bit sweetish, please go in for lemon. Don't add imli to the pineapple rasam. Just add some lemon juice in the end. But my pineapple rasam does not need it. See, the froth is there and I'm going to switch it off. Now last and not the least, all the rasams you have to add some curry leaves and coriander leaves. This is all fresh from the garden, washed and kept. Always wash the leaves well, even if it is from your garden. Wash the leaves and then use it. I'll show you all the rasams together. So this is the good rasam or the inner jiffy rasam. This is the kollu rasam or the horse cram rasam. And this is the very special pineapple rasam. Three types of rasams to last at least 3 seasons. You can make each day one rasam. Try out these recipes and enjoy the monsoon, the winter and the summer with rasams or thin lentil stew. Thank you from Sugar's Vegetarian Kitchen.